A label you wear with pride. I remember when I went to meet Meera, she actually said to me, you know what, Sushma, I am a proud homemaker. I wear this label with pride, isn't that? And you spend a lot of time at home.
I do, and I love it, you know. I had a tough pregnancy, and I would not want to spend... I went through those 5 months of a difficult time to bring my daughter into this world, both of us together. So now I want to spend every moment that I can with her. And I think that there is a set of responsibilities that are on my plate. And I feel that at my age, I have a lot more energy. I have a lot more, I have my future ahead of me. So I can finish all of my responsibilities and then have nothing in my way. You know, I can raise my daughter, I can be a good wife, I can set my house the way that I like. Not in terms of the way things should be, but the way a home must be with its values and with its ideals. So nothing will stop me after that. But I love being at home. I love being a mother to my child. I wouldn't have it any other way. I wouldn't want to spend 1 hour a day with my child and rush off to work. Why did I have her? She's not a puppy. You know, I mean, I want to be there for her as a mother. I wouldn't, seeing her grow up has, cannot be quantified.
Thank you for that. Meera, and this is something I know you've been very passionate about. There is this motherhood syndrome that's happening, that's going around.
Yeah.
Get fit immediately after you get, become a mother. The entire story of being the mother of today is the fit mother of today. And I'm not talking about, and there's a lot of body shaming that goes around as well. So your views on that, please.
I think we should, instead of, I mean, I think it's great to be fit, but it's better to be a healthy mother. So fitness is one part of health. So there is a lot of pressure. I faced a lot of pressure from, you know, people who were seeing photographs or anything. I myself would look at the mirror because I used to be a very skinny girl. And then after I had a baby, I remember I would never have to try clothes before. And then I would have to look at the size and see, okay, is this going to suit me? Is my tummy going to show and all of that? But I think what's more important is to be a healthy mother. Your child is your responsibility. So I have to be healthy. And you can take your time to lose that weight. If you do it in a hurry, you're compromising on your health. And it's not just physical health, it's a lot of mental health as well. You need to come to terms with the fact that your body is going to be different for a certain amount of time and it's not permanent. After that, you can set your goal and say, okay, I want to get fit. But I took my time. I took those 40 days, which people say is outdated. A confinement period is outdated. But I took those 40 days. I had my ghee. I had all of that. And I made sure that I replenished myself because I gave a lot to give birth to her.
Those days are lovely. Just those 40 days being taken care of.
Yeah, I loved it. I loved it.
Something I'll never forget.
I could step out 3-4 days later. I could be out and about. But I chose to spend that time with her because a baby doesn't know anyone except its mother
absolutely,
in those first
absolutely,
6 weeks.
Absolutely, absolutely.
So Meera, we're doing this conversation with you to get an insight in your life. We have had a few meetings and it was very interesting to note, and your background is really lovely. Actually, to put everyone in the loop, Meera shared with me 95% in bones is a total achiever. So I want to know, and I'm sure everyone here would like to know, a little bit about what your life has been doing for that.
Well, just from a normal family in Delhi, I have two younger sisters, we are a family of three girls, and I think the biggest
driving force behind all of us was the way our parents raised us, and especially my dad, because you know, he raised us to feel empowered.
And it's not fair to say that he raised me like a son. He raised me like a daughter, and I'm proud to be that today. And it was those small things. He would be a part of everything that I would do, whether it was choosing my subjects or which college I was to go to. And he always told me, don't strive for perfection, strive for excellence, because that is a constant process. You should be the best at what you do, but you don't have to be perfect, because there's beauty in imperfection. And it was always, we were always strong, but we were still sensitive. We were powerful, but we were not aggressive. And I can see that in my mother. You know, she has kept together all of us with such strong values. But that doesn't mean we're not, I would like to say, it doesn't mean we're not women of today. We have our values, but we're still modern. And you don't have to compromise on values, and you don't have to compromise on ideals that have been there in your family and traditions just to be modern. You can be modern, absolutely, and you can have values at absolutely the same time. They're not absolutely mutually exclusive.
Absolutely, absolutely. Completely agree with you on that. I don't know if I can ask, but I'm going to ask this anyway. You had an arranged marriage.
Yeah.
And that was, when I personally got to know it was an arranged marriage, it was very different. The fact that an arranged marriage in today's day and age with a film star, so could you please share if it's not being too personal?
Why not? Why not? Why wouldn't you get, you have to meet someone some way. And I just felt that this worked for both of us so beautifully because we both laid our cards right in the beginning. And today I was just talking to a friend of mine, and she happens to be going through the same process. And I said, just be yourself. That's what I did. Both of us. We were ourselves right from the beginning. And there was a different kind of discovery after marriage. But there was no surprise of a negative kind, I would say. Because I was who I was, and he was who he was. And I was comfortable. And I accepted the role that I had to take on, and he accepted that he has to become a part of my life. He also has to come into a family that is very into each other, we're extremely into each other, and being in films, you don't have that much time. And both of us, I think, have given and taken a lot from each other, and we've become more wholesome. You know, it's two halves that make a whole. So why not?
Why not? Meera, you are out of the fishbowl. Now you live a life in the fishbowl.
Yeah,
what's it
right
like?
In.
What's it like? Please share with us what it's like.
Well, at home, it's just like any other marriage. We have fights. We get along well. We laugh a lot. We raise our child together. We're best of friends. And when we step out, we're just two people together taking on the world, I would say. And we've, like I said, we've just given and taken a lot from each other. We've shared experiences. We've shared points of view. And I would say now, I never thought I'll be here. And it's not a bad thing. I'm glad that I can be, you know, the voice of a 22-year-old amongst a room full of so many accomplished women. And I was so nervous when you asked me. I said, what am I going to do? Because everyone here is so much more experienced. They're so much more accomplished. What am I going to do? But I feel that I can give you a point of view that's mine. And that's all. I hope you like it. And it's just another world. There's nothing wrong with it. It's a new world.
Accomplishment is a very strong word. What is accomplishment, according to you?
Accomplishment, I feel, would be achieving anything that you set your heart to. So, you can be an accomplished career woman. You can be an accomplished wife. You can be an accomplished mother. Accomplishment knows no bounds.
So, you're an accomplished homemaker. Tell me, Meera, empowered women, mm-hmm, and an empowered woman of today. man-women relationship. So it's the last question. So think about it. What, according to you, is an empowered woman and the relationship between a man and a woman? What, according to you, should it be?
I think empowerment means that you have the right to choose. You have the right to choose what you would like to do. So it is my choice if I want to be at home, and it is someone else's choice if they want to be a working mother. But both are equally valid, and neither of them should be shamed. And empowerment means also, it means, I feel, an inner strength. I think you need to have that sense of calm, and you need to have semblance in within so that you can take on the world, because you need to be, what I feel, you need to have that equilibrium within so that you can be powerful outside.
Lovely.
And yeah, and I feel that the relationship between a man and a woman, I mean, feminism today, feminism isn't woman versus man, it's men and women together. It's about equality. And there's this new wave of feminism that's come about, which is about aggression, and it's a lot, I feel it's very destructive, and it's going towards, I mean, I heard of this term called feminazi, which is the female equivalent of male chauvinist. I feel that there should be a harmony between the two sexes. If either of the two tries to take the place of the other, there will be chaos. And there just needs to be a harmony and a sense of equilibrium between the two.
A yin and a yang.
A yin and a yang.
Yes,
exactly.
Excellent. Yeah. Thank you, Meera. I really appreciate you taking this time.
Thank you so much.
Everyone, a round of applause for Meera.
Thank you.
Thank you for sharing your life and your insights and a little bit about you with all
of
us.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Happy Women's Day.